способствует уходить to certain pathological factor or disproportion of ratio between the spinal cord and the skin. In physiology, we know the most universal adaptative response of the body is inflammation. It's a response to any aggression. But not every inflammation should be corrected from outside. With some of these reactions, the body manages to cope with them. Where is the borderline between the deformities in which we have to conduct one treatment or other, even if we call it preventive? We do not know what this prevention may lead to.
When
do we have to conduct preventive treatment? When do we have to start surgical? What is the main criteria to choose method one and method two? It's a question to you. First, I want to admire the wonderful surgical work that was demonstrated by my old and good friend Mikhail Vitanovich. In spite of the fact that we are at different poles, at different extremes, on our way to resolve the problem of scoliosis, we still managed to resolve it. Mikhail Vitanovich showed us an excellent solution of very severe deformities, and here we speak about prevention of the progression and severe invalidization of children. He manages to bring these patients to new borders. Our position is prevention of the quality of life. Prophylaxis is on the quality of life from the point of view of the center that I am honored to head and our team. We mean that we try not to allow for scoliosis per se. So we pay attention to the growth of the spine, the shape of the spine, the stages of the symptoms developing up to the pathological threshold. From our point of view, prevention of prophylaxis means to leave my old friend without work. But then we would be able to sit together, and he goes all around the country, so he won't be left without work. He will continue to go on trips.
But
nevertheless, we look at prevention as not to allow the scoliosis at all. But there are many causes for scoliosis, and we still will exist. The genetics is working, yes, congenitive anomalies of development, dysfunctions of pineal gland, etc. All of them exist, but the answer is only the deformity, the response, and the final response of the organism. And those that are neglected will go to Mikhail Vitanovich, those who are not neglected come to us. When do we start to operate? Two options of the answer exist. The short one is I do not know. The longer one is
when
the deformity is visible. This is the easiest case.
But when
you see a patient like recently, last week actually, with a woman of 39 years, very good looking lady with two children, and she has around 60 degrees deformity. What do you want? You have a family, you have a husband, children, what else do you want? She actually couldn't answer the question. But she wants to be beautiful. And I know.
Доказывать ей необходимость операции я не имею никакого права.
Surgically, they always have time because we can operate until 50 years of age in scoliosis and even later. But I don't see any unified approach.
И это, кстати, вопрос, вот, который мы недавно обсуждали, три дня назад,
другой пациент,
эмерджентности, как говорим,
это совсем другое.
То есть, как по принципу, я знаю, что я ничего не знаю. И в каждом конкретном случае надо вместе с родителями принимать, ну, каждый
пациент,
но единого нет. А профилактика сегодня считалась
превеншн.
Теперь мне объяснили, что она есть, и я все равно могу
заговорить.
Мы закончили дискуссию, нам по плану.
We have finished the discussion.